Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video I am going to talk about the new screenshots in App Store Connect. So without further ado, let's get to work. Great. Now, if you are logging into your App Store Connect account, you will be greeted with this kind of message: screenshots and app previews for new devices now supported. What that means is, well, iPhone XS Max is out and you are going to need to add a new screenshots. Well, for now it is optional. It will be it won't be optional as of, I believe, March of next year, but it is a good thing to support new features of new devices, because Apple loves when you embrace their new stuff. So today we are going to talk about the dimensions and how you can use those dimensions of those new devices. So let's get into the nitty-gritty and let's learn some more. Before I dive in, let's learn some more. Okay, now here is the blog post or news that Apple released, and here are the new screenshot sizes. And this is for portrait, 1242x2688, and the other one is for a landscape. Now, let us just go into let's click this learn about uploading screenshots. Let's open this in a new tab, and I will guide you where you can actually take a look at the exact dimensions what you need to upload. So let's just scroll down here and you will see screenshot specification. Okay, let's click on that, or just find this in the menu. And here you go. As you can see, the Super Retina display is now, or for now, it is optional. Now, required is the 5.5 inch for iPhones, and for iPad, the 12.9 inch is required. And here are the dimensions. Of course, you don't have to go in this deep to know what you have to do, because I have prepared a special zip file which you can download by clicking on the link down below. It's on my site. You just enter your email and get a hold of these free dimensions. And why do I say free dimensions? Because in App Store Connect you only need to upload three dimensions, and what one is for the Super Retina display, one is for the 5.5 inch display, and the other one is for iPad. So let's take a look at that before I show you the actual sizes and how I would go about it, because I will of course show you by example, as always, how you can upload. So let's go one into one of my clients that I'm working on. It is called See It Buddy, and I'm under App Store. Click on prepare for submission. Now I am pretty sure that you already know this, and here we go: app previews and screenshots. This is where you need to drag and drop your screenshots. So as you can see, the 6.5 display iPhone is optional for now. It won't be as of March next year. And here we have our 5.5 inch display for iPhone, and of course our iPad 12.9 display. Okay, now how do you actually make those screenshots? Well, first of all, you create it either on your device, but if you don't have all of these three devices, then you can do so on your simulator. So I will just start here. I already have Xcode opened and I have prepared the simulators. So what I will do is go ahead and create all of these screenshots. Okay, first of all, let's launch our iPhone XS Max, and as you can see, it's a simple app. You just download these catalogs and take a look at it. Go ahead and type in See It Buddy in the App Store and download it. If you are watching this in the near future, it's not up just yet, but it will be. Okay, now, how do you make a screenshot? Well, it's pretty simple. Go to File and New Screenshot. Great. Now go to your desktop and under Screenshots, there will be, where is my screenshot? Simulator Screenshot. Here we go. This is my simulator screenshot. And we are going to add this into our App Store Connect. And as you might have already guessed, this will not always work. So I will just drag and drop it here. Okay, let's wait for it. And if it doesn't work, I will show you a little trick how you can add the perfect sized images here. Well, it did work. It seems that the Xcode simulator guys worked this out. The screenshot wasn't always the same size. Okay, now you can do this. Let's take a look if we have our other simulator working on. So let's launch this guy. Wait for it. And click on File, New Screenshot. Okay, now let's try to drag and drop into the iPhone 5.5-inch display. Okay, let's take a look. Here we go. Let's wait for it. Yeah, it's working. It is working. So the guys figured this out. You don't really need to download resources, but anyway, if you do want to, go ahead and download it. You can take a look at the free device sizes. It's not it is compulsory. Okay, now you have a pop-up here and it says app previews and screenshots and localizations. We'll use your 5.5-inch display app preview and screenshots for all iPhone display sizes. That is what we want to do. So click on OK. Now let's go to iPad and select your simulator and let's run this. Why I actually made those screen sizes in Photoshop is that because in earlier versions of the simulator, the sizes weren't actually the same sizes as Apple requires them. But now they fixed it. Good on you, Apple. So let's create a new screenshot here. And as you can see, we have a portrait mode in iPhone and a landscape mode in the iPad version of the app, and that is perfectly fine. Okay, let's go into our App Store Connect and drag and drop our simulator screenshot. And while we wait, let's talk about some of the advantages, of course, why you want to add these largest images, and that is because the App Store actually shrinks all of them down to the right size, and that is why this is so important. So we'll use your 12.9-inch display. Let's click on OK, and great. And one last thing you need to click on is save, and it is saving now. I just figured that you actually need to download those resources anyway if you don't want to add these basic app screenshots. If you want to add some design to it, some text, some logo, or you just want to split it up, you can do so with the help of these resources. And I will show you what I mean and what I have prepared for you. So let's look at YouTube here and screenshots. And here we have our free screenshots. And I will open all of these in Photoshop. Okay, let's wait for that. And what you need to know is once you have these, you can just simply drag and drop your screenshots inside or create other fancy stuff like add a title or something like that. So here you have our 5.5 inch and our iPad screenshots. Go ahead and click the link down below to get these resources for free. And that is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to see more videos on iOS development. Now it's your turn. Go ahead and add a link down below in the comments to your app so I may see your screenshots created with these awesome resources. And don't forget to add your 6.5 inch Super Retina display screenshots too, so we may enjoy it in the iPhone XS Max displays. Okay, I will see you in the next one.